Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. Guys, you're going to love this. In this particular video, I'm going to go into a full explanation of burning and dodging. Your number one takeaway in this particular video has to be the essence of burning and dodging. How important is burning and dodging in beauty retouching or in portrait retouching? Guys, let me dive into this. If you don't want to go into this explanation that I'm going to give you for why we do certain things and how we do certain things, you can skip ahead. Time codes in the description below, and of course skip to the actual process. But I'm first going to take you through into the whys and hows for those of you who really want to learn something. Anyhow, let's dive into this. First of all, what is burning and dodging? Now, burning and dodging is it is actually one of the retouching techniques we use when we're doing beauty retouching. Basically, burning is darkening, dodging is brightening. That is how I can explain it as in a layman's language. Let me just explain it to you here. Let me just create a new document here. File, new. And then I'll just create a new document just like that. So now this is the new document. I'll just create a new layer here. Let me just undo this. So we are going to get, let us create an egg here. Like, this is our egg. Yeah. And we are going to give it, let us give it brown skin tones, skin colors. Okay. Are those the skin colors? Okay. Yes. So I'm just going to come here and cover it all up with yellow. So with that particular brown color. So when you look at it right now, it is flat. Yeah. But what is burning? Now, if I came here and created a new layer right here and then got my brush and got black, let me get black, and then I'll just make the brush soft, and then I came and painted that side. Now I've done what they call burning. And if I created another layer and got white from here and painted that side, that is dodging. Now, do you see what has happened to this particular thing? Let me just put this in a group for you, so that you get what I'm talking about. Now, let me just show you. Look at, that's the before and that is the after. Now, burning and dodging has given it a dynamic feel. You feel like you can go all around this particular egg and go all around it. Now, that is exactly what burning and dodging does to your images. Most people don't explain it this way, but I feel this is the layman's language of explaining burning and dodging. Basically, you're going to create depth into your whole images. You're going to create that dynamic feel into your images. You know, when you do frequency separation, most of the times the image turns out flat, but burning and dodging is what brings back the depth and dimension into a portrait, and it creates that feel of presence in all through the image. Let me just go back to this particular image. So when you look at this image, it really got flat in the post-production, in during the frequency separation technique. Now, the burning and dodging is what is going to bring it back into that three-dimensional feel. But again, under burning and dodging, there are two kinds of burning and dodging. We have the global burning and dodging and the micro burning and dodging. Now, the micro burning and dodging, what it does, if you're not going to use the Gaussian blur and the mixer brush to do your frequency separation, usually we use micro burning and dodging to edit these micro pores, because a human skin has a bit of grooves and the like. So you use micro burning and dodging to enhance these particular things. We are not going to look at micro burning and dodging today. Today we are just going to look at the global burning and dodging for the sake of creating depth in an image. Ready? Let's dive into it. Now, how do we do burning and dodging? Now, here we're going to come into hue. saturation, and we're going to use curves. Yes, we're using curves adjustment layers. So you come here and say curves, and then you pull this down so that you have, you say, I want the intensity of my shadows to be that thick. So we are going to call this burn. Okay, then we're going to create a hue saturation layer, because when you look at it, the shadows get a bit desaturated when you pull down the curves. So what we do, we come here and create a hue saturation layer and increase the saturation just a little bit, you know, like that. I don't take it beyond 13, especially if you're working with dark skin. So you come, we want this effect to only work on the burn layer. Okay, so we come and clip it by clicking here. See, this is where I need your maximum attention. Now you're going to press to click onto the burn layer again and press Control or Command I on your keyboard to invert the mask. So you're going to do the same thing for the dodge. How are you going to do that? You come here into the curves and look into adjustment layers rather, and say curves. Now you're going to come and pump up the curves. Now look at what happens to the highlights and midtones. They tend to yellow out, which is a sign of saturations. We don't want our highlights to be saturated. Okay, so what do? We still do the same thing, create a hue adjustment layer like that. Okay, and then you get, what are we going to do now? We are going to reduce saturation. Okay, so you come and pull down saturation like that. See that? Don't take it beyond for you to have your highlights pale. No, you just come and bring it around a -9 is enough. So what you're going to do, you guessed right, we are going to clip this mask so that this effect only applies to this. So you come and clip it. So we are going to rename this and put it dodge. Now watch this. Let me just put this in a group. Before I put them in a group, I'm still going to click on through here and press Control or Command I if you're using a Mac on my keyboard to invert these particular things. Okay, so I'm going to come here and then click onto the burn layer, press Shift onto my keyboard, click onto the topmost layer, which is the hue saturation layer, and put this in a group like that. So I'm just going to call this burn and dodge. Okay, now guess what we are going to do? Yes, you guessed right, we are going to begin burning this image. And what are we going to use? You guessed again right, we are going to use the brush tool. Okay, so you come click onto the brush tool just there. Let us zoom this in, and then we are going to get the brush tool, and then we begin burning. But you may be wondering, okay, where, how do I know what to burn and what not to burn? Let me explain this to you in a layman's language. Have you ever been onto a makeup set where a makeup artist is doing makeup, and you see them after they have finished applying foundation and the like, then they begin painting like a white thing on top of the nose, then they begin painting highlighter on the cheekbones all the way like that? Now they are doing what they call contouring, and this is what you as a photographer are going to be doing in this particular thing. The reason as to why they do contouring is to emphasize certain parts of an image and silence certain parts of an image. If somebody has a flat nose like mine, definitely they will give him a very light nose contour right on top of their nose, so that when somebody looks in front of them, they get that illusion of, hey, this nose is sharp. That is what they do in order to create depth. And if they want to emphasize cheekbones, definitely they will put highlighter on top, which is dodging in our case. So let me just create a help layer here, okay, just for your guide. Now you see, when you look at this, now when we are doing beauty retouch, most of the times I'm going to get a brush tool. I'm just going to get a random color here. Let me just use a Okay, here, let me use a purple to represent the parts that we are going to burn now. Okay, now, when we are doing beauty retouch, the goal is, of course, to imitate what makeup artists do. So what are we going to do? We need to create more attention around the face area, okay? And by just following the way light is hitting the subject. So we are going to burn all around this side here, all around the face, like that. Then we are going to burn aside the nose there. We're going to burn into the cheekbone area so that we emphasize the jawline and give, you know, because we are trying to imitate the beauty mask. We may also burn the mascara around the eyes. Okay, I don't like burning over the eyebrows because I don't like having the eyebrows looking too black. They tend to come off very, very weird, in my opinion. That is a question of personal taste. And in fact, I usually tell makeup artists when I'm doing makeup that, hey, don't give me a black eyebrow, give me a dark brown eyebrow because it looks more real. So we just come and burn into these. Do you realize what I'm doing? We are following the way the shadows are hitting the whole image. We are going to burn all through here, and of course you're going to burn around here, there. And of course, to emphasize the cleavage, we are just going to burn around here and also burn around here. And then here at the edges, you get the point. You realize everywhere that light did not hit, that is where we're going to burn. And what about dodging? You may be wondering. Now, for dodging, I'm going to show you a trick, okay? You don't even have to select anything like we do for burning. The hard work is in the burning, okay? And then you're just going to, well, let me just delete this. That was just a help layer, okay? But now you get the point. So we get onto the burn layer. We zoom our picture in, and then I'm just going to come right here. I make sure my brush is soft. So I'm just going to get my brush, leave the opacity at 100, and then get the flow at 2, okay? So you come, get your brush tool, make sure it's white that is on top. And guess what we're going to do? We're going to begin by burning around the face, okay? To create more emphasis so that we bracket the face out like that. Just like that. All around the face so that we bracket it in. Then I'll just come. I first do general burning, like burning general stuff, like that. You may not be seeing the effect, but let me just show you. That is the before and that is the after, okay? Okay, I don't know what's wrong with my computer. I'll just select another image here and then let me come back. Okay, don't know why it is doing that. Is it the graphics card? Anyhow, so you come still under here. We finished bracketing the face. Then you come into this and then you still come and burn all around here. You know, you remember where we said we are burning? Then you come also here around the cheekbone area, then we burn in the cheekbones like that. Still here, we do the same. And then we come here, we burn around that area to emphasize that. I also come and burn just around here to emphasize that particular jawline. Okay, now let us look at the before and after. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. Let me just show you what we exactly burned. I'll press just Alt on my keyboard to see what we did. Look at that. See what we did? That is how we burn. It is that simple, guys. It is not complicated. So we are going to still come and just burn all around the mascara area here. This is very beautiful makeup. The makeup was done by a lady called Faith Brush, a very, very awesome makeup artist. And the lady here, this is a musician, her name is Kimba, and a Ugandan artist, very super talented. So I'll come and burn through. So let me just press Alt here and you see how that is how we burn. And when you look at it, you don't have to be a great artist, by the way, to do this. When you look at this, we have done practically nothing of that is so artistic, really. Okay, so now the next thing we are going to do, we're going to do what they call the dodge. This is where I need your maximum attention, okay? Guys, I don't know what's wrong with my computer. I don't know whether I'm getting these things. Okay, let me just get back here so that I hide them. So How do we do the dodging? So when you want to do the dodging, you click here. Okay, now I need your maximum attention so that you don't get lost here. Okay, leave whatever you're doing. Hey, leave whatever you're doing. Let us focus here, okay? Now you come here into the dodge. Oh, by the way, if you've not yet subscribed to this channel, click the subscribe button. Let me just give you a moment. Done? Awesome. Now let's continue. Now you get onto the dodge layer, you click, and then you press Control I or Command I on your keyboard to invert this particular layer. Watch this. Control I. Okay? So watch what I'm going to do here. From dodge, you come here into select. See here? You're going to look. Guess where we're going to go? You guessed right. Color range right here. Now look what I'm going to do. You just come here and select highlights. Okay? Now the range, when you look at this range, you're asking Photoshop that, hey, I want these effects to be in this range from here to this, from here. For our case, we only want this particular effect to be in the highlight. So we are going to come and begin cutting down the range like that. See how it is only creating itself in the highlight zone? See? Like that. Look here. Look at this. Okay? Now, fuzziness is like creating a gradation from light to shadow. Look at it as making the effect more gradual so that it's not graphical. So we just come and either increase it or cut it down if we don't want it to. We don't want this to go in so much into the shadow area. into the shadow area. So we come and cut down the fuzziness just a little bit. You know, the problem we have is that it has brought in this, but I'm going to show you how to undo that. So you come here and say okay. Ready? Now watch this. Look at this. That's the before, that's the after. It has already given us a starting point, guys. This is an awesome starting point. So let me just show you how we are going to now undo this graphical feel. So you press Alt on your keyboard. Yes, so you see this? And then click onto the mask to invert. Yeah, to see whatever is happening on the mask. Then you come here into, with the mask selected, you come here into Filter, you say Blur, and say Gaussian Blur, okay? Remember, we want to cut down that graphical feel the fuzziness brought. So you look here and we come and blur it out. Like that. Here, right here. So guess what we're going to do? Right now, we are all still going to press Alt on our keyboard to bring back the mask. And look at that. And now we're going to just come and cut down the opacity like that. Just like that. Look at that. That's the before and that's the after. You can even cut it down as far as you want. Look at that. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. Basically, you have done dodging without even overly going into all that stuff of selecting that you have to dodge this, you have to dodge that. Now, if you want to emphasize, for example, I want to emphasize the cleavage here. This is where I come into my layer mask. I get my brush here, and then I just come right here and then just paint it further and re-emphasize it myself like that, so that the cleavage is I still come and do the same thing here, the same here. I mean, how cool is that, guys? Now let us see the before and after. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. See how we've created depth in the face? I'll zoom it in for you. Let me show you. That's the before, that's the after. Before and after. Isn't that beautiful, guys? Anyhow, that's that for today, guys. I'll see you in my next tutorial. If you've really taken out value in this video and feel like you would love to buy me a cup of coffee, click the first link in the description below. And if you've not yet subscribed to this channel, come on, join the family now and let us take your photography career forward. Let us make you more money with these amazing tutorials. I'll see you in my next tutorial and adios.